It's Lisbon's first amphibious vehicle, offering our customers the ability to see and experience the city both on land and water, which up until this point wasn't possible. In 2005, I was at Harvard University studying for my MBA, and I took a course there, which is to evaluate an entrepreneurial opportunity. And I originally grew up in Toronto. My family, both my mom and father, are Portuguese, and I always had the desire to move to Portugal. So the focus of that, the lens which I tackled that opportunity was, if I were to move to Lisbon, what business would I start? And when you start doing that analysis, focusing on tourism is one of the first things that comes to mind. The vehicle itself is the same as a traditional truck. So from a highway point of view or from a bus point of view, there's no difference there. The engine itself has a power takeoff, which gives us the ability to have a second transmission shaft, which then goes to a marine transmission. And then it's a traditional propeller with a rudder. And the moment we enter in the water, we engage that. The moment that the vehicle enters the water is obviously the high point. There's a very distinct sensation as the vehicle enters the water. The front begins to float, the rear of the vehicle is obviously still in contact with the land, and then at the moment that stops to be the case, and you sense it start to float, there's a real an adrenaline rush.
Andar na água.
The part when went to the river. Yes.
Hippotrip's plans, or in terms of expanding our operation in Lisbon, is to increase the number of vehicles in our fleet. We do have a second vehicle here right now that's in the process of getting homologated, certified. We expect it to be much easier than the first one because obviously it's in the exact same condition and all the modifications have already been made. And the idea is to hopefully increase our fleet here, let's say 3 or 4 vehicles, while expanding opportunities in other cities in Portugal and throughout Europe as well.